Today we will be discussing about the educational philosophy of Froebel. Here we will see the life sketch of Froebel, and then we will see the philosophical belief of Froebel. Then we will also see that what kind of educational experimentation and innovation he had in his mind and he has experimented. There are two things which is contributed by Froebel in the field of education. One is the kindergarten system of education. I think you must be very familiar with the LKG, UKG, this type of word, and upper kindergarten and the lower kindergarten, LKG, UKG. But this concept of a kindergarten is proposed by the Froebel. He proposed, he thought, and then he has experimented. Then the world came to know about his scheme of educating the budding young children. Budding children. So, at that time, he had faced a lot of a problem because of his innovative thoughts and idea. As we know that and it is even now, it was not like that during that time he faced. Even now, if you will have a very innovative, very new idea, then the people will not accept easily. People will not digest easily. And that was the situation at that time also. And even we have seen some other philosophers also, when they have come with their own innovative idea, then they were facing the problem of the governance of the people, of the system, because it is actually a revolt against the system, a revolt against the existing practices. We are used to live in the practices which we have. We are comfortable, we are in the comfort zone. When someone will be proposing something new, so it will be making you discomfort. So, since you will be discomforted, and that's why people will not easily accept your innovative ideas and thought. And that was the with the Froebel also. When we talk about the Froebel's full name is the Friedrich August Froebel. He was a German philosopher, and he is basically known as for the contribution of kindergarten and play schools, playway methods. These are his major contribution in the field of education. And his contribution is only for the children. He had not worked, he has not philosophized the education for the higher education or the elementary education or a secondary education. Not. He was only concerned towards the budding children. And the kindergarten scheme that was proposed by the Froebel is supposed to be most original, attractive, and the philosophically sound from the infant development point of view. Okay, so that is the most original version. However, later on, so many other person have also contributed in the field of a kindergarten education, like when we talk about the Montessori, Montessori system. She also contributed that how we can educate the coming children, those who are in the early age. She has also contributed. But this is the most original and this is the most innovative idea that was contributed by the Froebel. And it is also accepted by later on. However, at that time, it was not accepted by the government. But later on, it was accepted by all over the world, the educators, the parents, and or simply you can say that those who are working in the field of education, they have accepted the idea and the philosophy of kindergarten proposed by Froebel. Basically, a kindergarten is the effective way of dealing with the highly teachable moment in the life of a child. Why we used to say that the highly teachable moment? We know that when you will see the educational psychology or even the learning psychology, better to say. When you will see the learning psychology and the development of a brain in the child, you will find that when the child is growing up, when the child is in the age of 2 to 3 up to 5 6 years, then the child is capable of learning very quickly and learning so many of a thing. Even when you will compare yourself or myself, when I will compare with the child, the rate of learning of a child will be always more than that how I will be learning, the rate of learning of me. It will be always better for them. I may learn slowly, or something I may not learn now, but the children can learn very quickly. And I was giving in the previous class also, I was giving one example of that, the child that she is able to understand 4-5 language when she is 2 or 2.5 year old. Able to understand means she can respond to those language, means they can understand. If you are responding, means you are understanding. Okay. So, and the kindergarten, when we talk, so he was dealing with the most teachable moment of the child, because at that time, the child is able to learn at a very fast rate. That was the point of a saying. And he has also introduced a playway method in the teaching learning process that makes Froebel an outstanding philosopher, and that's why the Froebel stands out from the other person who we are working for educating the children. Because the playway method was a very innovative method, and it was a joyful method. But that is the more interesting. It was a joyful method where that learning process was not a kind of a burden on the part of the children. Children were enjoying, because the children were learning by the playing. It was not like that children were supposed to sit at a place or stand at a place or to be at a place and whatever it is taught by the teacher, and that they are supposed to learn. Like that now, what you are doing? You are sitting at a place. You are bound to sit at a place. And whatever I am saying, that you are listening. It may be not more enjoyable than when you will be allowed free to explore the thing. And by learning, by playing, by interacting, you will learn something. That will be more interesting than what is now. Okay, so that's why the Froebel is a different kind of a philosopher than the philosopher of his time. Okay, but to develop all those things, Froebel has suffered a lot. We know that in order to get the thing, we have to work, and that the Froebel did. Froebel is also said to be a father of a sociological trend in education, because the sociological perspective were not taken care in the education before that. Now we know that there is an implication of a sociology in the education, there is an implication of philosophy in education, there is an implication of a psychology in education. There is a lot of a thing that influences the education, now we know. But before that, the sociological perspective were not taken into the education at that time. And that's why he is known to be the father of implementing, father of sociological trend in education. Okay, he born in the very small village of South Germany in April 21st, 1782. Very small family. And he lost his mother when the Froebel was only 9 months old. All those things, why I am explaining why I used to explain, so that you can understand what was the situation, what was the life condition of a philosopher in which they have grown their philosophical idea. They have developed their philosophical idea. Because it is a situation, it is a condition where the philosophical idea develops. Like that, when you will be suffering, when you will be enjoying, so that time also your mind works and you think that how and why it is happening. And it molds your thought. So when he was a 9-month-old only, he lost his mother. Then his father married again when he was a 4-year-old. So when his father is marrying, so he got a stepmother. But the attitude of a stepmother was not very good towards him. And his father was also not able to pay attention towards him. And the stepmother was also treating him very badly. This kind of a situation, even now it is also happens in some condition. Okay, the stepmother, they don't treat their stepchildren as their. Okay, so that was also prevailing at that time, and the stepmother was not treating him in a genuine way, and the father was also not able to pay the attention, and that's why the Froebel became a neglected child towards whom nobody was paying the attention. Neglected child. This situation is observed by his maternal uncle. Maternal uncle, now in the India, we used to say mama, hai na? Means your mother's brother, hai na? Maternal uncle. That was observed by him, and he thought that it will not be good to leave the Froebel in those condition, and that's why the maternal uncle brought him and put in a school when he was a 10-year-old. So the Froebel started schooling at the age of 10 years. You can just think of nowadays what we are doing. When the child is 2, 3, 4 years, we put in the some sort of a schooling process, whether it is a LKG, UKG or standard 1 or whatever it is. But we try to put them in the schooling process. But the Froebel started his schooling at the age of 10 years when his maternal uncle seen the condition is very pathetic, and the Froebel is becoming a neglected child, and the Froebel is being attracted towards the ill practices. However, the Froebel stayed with his maternal uncle with about 4 years. Okay, and since he have started his education at 10 years, and the development of Froebel was not much taken care, so he was a dull student in the class. And then he thought he cannot continue for the education, and then he left the school and he started an apprenticeship with a forester. And a forester means those who take care of a forest in a particular region. So he started apprenticeship with a forester. And that was the one of the life-changing moment of the Froebel. There is a several life-changing moment which has molded the thought of a Froebel in a different way. There are some situation. So at this point of time, when he started apprenticeship with a forester, he got opportunity to see the forest, to spend time in the forest, and by this kind of activity he developed an intimate kind of a relationship with the environment, with the nature. Okay, and he started learning about the natural phenomena, and he had developed an interest towards the nature. He wanted to explore more and more about the nature, and He says that during that time he has received a real education in the lap of nature. That was the one turning moment for the Froebel. The again turning moment of the Froebel was that his father was a religious person. So he has got some sort of influence of his father. And then his maternal uncle was also a religious person. So he got some influence from his maternal father as well. And he develops a religious thought with the influence of his father and the maternal uncle. And from where he tried to develop himself as an idealistic philosopher. He inclined towards the idealism because of the practices, because of the spending the time in the nature. He started developing the thought as an idealistic philosopher, or better you can say that as an idealism. And when he saw the children, then he started developing the intense sympathy for the children and thought of spending whole life for promoting the better life for the children. Because he has seen the environment, he has seen the nature very closely. He was exposed to the religion and all those things. He was exposed to the Kant and like that, the idealistic philosopher. He was influenced by those philosophers. So he had a sympathy for the children and thought of devoting his life, whole life, for the betterment of the children, for bringing better condition for the children. And as per his interest in the natural science, because he was working as an intern, doing the internship with the forester. So he developed an interest to learn more about the nature. And to learn more about the nature, he joined University of Jena as the age of 18 years. But he cannot completed the education at a University of Jena because of the financial constraint. He could not complete the education. And he was not completed. Then after, he thought of leaving because he was not able to complete because of the financial conditions. So after leaving the University of Jena, he started again, he enrolled himself in the University of Frankfurt. And there he started studying the architecture. Wherein, and see, this was the second turning point of the Froebel. He left the course there, that was the course in the environment, university course, and then he joined the University of Frankfurt. And in during his study of the architecture, he came to the contact with Dr. Gerner, who was a director of a model school, who identified the potential of the Froebel. And he suggested that you can be a better teacher. Why not you start teaching? You will be a better teacher. You are safe for being a teacher. So that was suggested by him. And he requested to join the school. But the Froebel thought that if he want to be a teacher, he has to join a school, then why not I should get some sort of a training, some sort of orientation on how to teach the children. And in order to learn all those things, the Froebel visited Pestalozzi Institute. And Pestalozzi is also a great philosopher of that time, even now also. Pestalozzi is even now relevant. So he visited the Pestalozzi Institute and learned how to teach, and he taught 2 years there also. But in between, because the Froebel was not a dumb type of a person who will accept everything that is coming to him. He had his own thought also. So when he was learning at a Pestalozzi Institute and when he was teaching at a Pestalozzi Institute, he was not angry with all the things. However, he learned there, but he was not angry. He got disagreement with the Pestalozzi that whatever you are doing, that is not a correct way. He got disagreement. And because of that disagreement and because of his original thought, he left the Pestalozzi Institute by resigning the job and joined the Göttingen University in 1811 to obtain a university education in the natural science, because his first love was also to explore the nature. Because when we see that after coming to the school, he had joined as an apprenticeship to the forester. So the nature was also his first love. So he enrolled in the natural science once again. First, he tried to study about the nature in the University of Vienna, where he could not due to the financial constraint. Again, he joined the Göttingen University to study about the natural sciences. But again, he could not complete due to the certain constraint. Then at that time, he joined the army to fight against the Napoleon. And he joined the army. And that was the again the next turning point. These were the incident which was shaping the thought of the Froebel. And when he joined the army to fight against the Napoleon, in the army, we know that there is a very strict rules and regulation you have to follow. There is a very much significance of rules, regulation and the unity. And that is taught to him during when he was in the army. In the army, he accepted that I have learned the value of discipline and unity when I was in the army. That was the contribution of that job in shaping his thought and practices of the Froebel. So he learned there the spirit of discipline and unity. But he left this job also after 3 years and become a curator in the Berlin Museum. And he could not continued that also for a long time as he was interested in the education. We know that his he was very much fond of the education and he was very much fond of the learning about the nature. So this was his first interest. But however, for satisfying his financial need, he joined the post of a curator in the Berlin Museum. Okay, but his love was for education and his love was for nature. So in order to satisfy his own love, in the 1816, he establishes a small school. He establishes a small school at Grinsen and later on it is transferred to the Kenhan, where he developed and explained his own principles and a method of instruction. Because we know that when he was teaching at a Pestalozzi Institute, he was not agree with the ideas and philosophy of a Pestalozzi. So whatever the thought and idea he had, he experimented those idea in his own school. And for that he has established a school in the 1816. And the play and artwork were the main feature of this school. Play and artwork, that was the main feature of this school. Then, based upon his philosophical thought, he published a very famous book. The name of the book is The Education of a Man in the 1826. because at that time he has shaped his thought, he has experimented his philosophical thoughts, and he comes with a very innovative idea in a book. The book name is The Education of a Man, wherein he states that a true method of education consists in considering the mind of the child as a whole, in which all the parts work together to produce a harmonious unity. The point of saying is that we should not think that the different part of a senses, different faculty of a mind work alone, rather than it is an integration of a whole body and a mind. It is an integration of a whole body and a mind. And when they work in a harmonious unity, then the wonderful thing can be done. So we should not treat them apart. And when the education comes, they should be trained simultaneously. There should be no much emphasis in the physical education or much emphasis in the intellectual part or emotional part, rather than there should be an equal emphasis on all. And in order to experiment his own idea, he started many schools in the Germany. But we know that when you will come up with some innovative idea, that will attract the government. And that's why the government, German government, got a disagreement with the revolutionary idea of the Froebel and set up a commission to conduct an inquiry about functioning of these schools. However, when the committee submitted his report, the functioning of a school, they have given a positive response. And they say, I will read that line, what they say when they have inquired the schools. They say that, I found here a closely united family of some 60 numbers members to held together in a mutual confidence, and every member seeking the good of the whole. The aim of institution is by no means knowledge and society merely, but free self-active development of mind from within. So by this quote, they have given a positive response on functioning of these schools. So the Froebel was saved in some way. However, because of functioning schools, when you are not getting the financial assistance, it is a difficult task. And that's why he was facing a financial difficulty in continuing his task. So, in the 1830, he shifted to the Switzerland. The government of Switzerland here appreciated the work of the Froebel. In the Germany, he was not appreciated. Even when he has established a school, an inquiry was set up to see the functioning of a school. But when he moved to the Switzerland government has appreciated his work. And not only the appreciated, he has been given a task to train the teachers. The existing teacher must be trained by him. He has been assigned a work. He started continuing the teacher training, but as he continued the task of a teacher's training, he became concerned about the non-availability of the education to the children at the preschool. He was training the teacher, But during that time, he came to know that there is a scarcity of a teacher, those who can teach at a preschool level. Preschool, that is a kindergarten. And when he realized that that is the crucial age, because Froebel was in opinion that this is the most productive mind of the child. And this, in this time, their mind is more productive. And that was ignored by the current educational practices at that time. So he returned back to the Germany in 1836, after 6 years, and established his first kindergarten in 1837. After 1 year, he established a formal school setup of a kindergarten. Okay, and here Froebel devoted his whole life for discovering the methods, modality, and the designing the aids for the kindergarten. But this was not appreciated by the German government, because the German government was also not appreciating him earlier also, whatever he was doing. So it was not appreciated, and government has restricted him to establishing their schools, because earlier he was also not appreciated in the Germany. So again, the German government has not appreciated, and he was restricted to by establishing any schools. And this incident has hurted the Froebel so deeply, because he has a love for the children. He had a love for the nature. He thought of establishing the school, and he had devoted his whole life for the betterment of the children. But that was not being appreciated by the government. And lastly, he had been restricted to establish any more schools. And on 21st June 1852, he passed away in the poverty, sufferings, and with so much of a pain, he passed away. Because he was not earning for himself. Whatever he was earning, that he was spending for the development of a kindergarten. So financially, he was not very much sound. That's why his last age, last time, he was a very poor, with a very financial crisis. He died in a poverty with so much of a suffering. But there was a several turning point that was shaping the Froebel. Okay, so that was about the life of the Froebel. When we talk about the philosophy of a Froebel, because during that he was not only the suffering, but he was developing his thought, and we have seen that there was a several turning point in his life, and he come with a very distinct philosophy. He talks about the principle of diversity, wherein in the principle of diversity he says that, because we know that the Froebel was the idealistic philosopher. So he see the whole universe as a gift from the God. The whole universe is a gift from the God. And with this faith, he formulated the principle of unity of a man, nature, and a God. What this the principle of a unity of a man, nature, and a God is, he says that man must be aware of absolute unity of the universe. The real purpose of education is to extend and expand or develop the life of an individual until it comprehends this to the existence through the participation in all preventing spiritual activity. In this book, he says that the Pratibha is joining now. In his book, we have seen that book, The Education of a Man, he says that the whole world, the all universe, is the union of a spiritual with a material. Material and spiritual, it is the union. God is the grounds of all the things. God is all comprehending and all sustaining. God is the essential part of this universe. That's why you say that all the things that have come from the divine unity, that is a God, have their origin in the divine unity. And he says the three types of a unity. The first is the unity of a substance, which means that there is the only one substance from which all the things has come. There is a one substance. Unity of a origin means there is a one place from all the things have been originated. And there is a unity of a purpose. And all the things which is originated, all the things which is there in the universe, which has come for the only one purpose. And the purpose is towards the strive towards the perfection, that is the God. Because the God is the perfection. So we have to strive toward the perfection, that is the God. That is, he says, the philosophy of unity in diversity. Diversity means even though we are different, we are from the different parts, different place, we are not alike, but we have come here for a single thing. The unity of substance, all are a part of a same thing. Unity of origin, all of us come from a same place, and a unity of a purpose. We have come here for a same purpose, that is to strive for the perfection towards the perfection, that is the God. So that's why there is a no meaning and the no place of a diversity. Even in the diversity, we are alike. That is the principle of unity in diversity as per the Froebel. Then the next principle is that principle of development. He says that the balanced and unified development of the body, mind and a soul. These three things should be balanced and unified. Mind, body and soul. Because he believes that the life is ever changing and growing. And the development should take place from within and strive towards the unity. Because when we talk about the development is derived from the principle of unity in diversity. That's why he is saying that all the developmental part of a mind, body and a soul must be focused towards the unity in diversity. Okay, then the next is the principle of self-activity. And he says that play as the most suitable medium of a self-activity. You can play. Play is the most suitable because anybody can play. There is none other work than play that can be performed by all the people. But play is the kind of a thing which attracts all the people and that can be performed by all kind of people. So play is the most suitable medium of self-activity. But any forced activity that is not appreciated, even if it is a play. Forced activity is the artificial and unnatural as per the problem. So the forced activity should not be done. And that's why in the kindergarten, when you see, we will discuss about the kindergarten in the detail, you will find that in the kindergarten, the self activity and a play of a child is appreciated. The forced and a restricted play is not appreciated, even though the child is playing. Child must be allowed to play what he wants to play. Not like that what you will allow to play. Isn't it? In his concept of a kindergarten. He allows the full freedom for the child through the self-composed joy, freedom, action like that. So that is the concept of a principle of a self-activity. He also talks about the principle of development in the social setting, because he thinks that the development of a human mind and a body can happen in the society. It cannot happen in the isolation. The child cannot develop in the isolation. Child can develop only when they are in the social setting. And that's why he advocates the individual integration and social cohesion. He further says, no community can progress while the individual remains behind. And as per the Froebel, true education of the individual is only possible when its relationship with the education of the whole society is realized. That is, the education can happen only in the social setting. And the last principle that he says, that the principle of a kindergarten, which is based upon the basic principle of Froebel, and where he says that kindergarten is the nursery of the future citizen. Like that, when we prepare a nursery of a plant, which is the future plant. He says that the kindergarten is the nursery of a future citizen, and the teacher is the gardener, who is nurturing the students, nurturing the future plants. So the kindergarten is visualized by the Froebel in that sense. And this is a place where the children can be inculcated the sense of a socialization and a self-realization. Okay, so that was the principle of a kindergarten of the Froebel.